Hi.
So, I called the landlord. We're good to let the lease go.
Okay.
Part of the theme of Ray Donovan, in L.A. at least, was ever-present sunshine and a lot of reflections. The standing orders is that everybody in post, and in the terms of the color timing, is just to make me happy. And you don't get that very often as a DP. And they also embrace, letting stuff play in wide shots, like that shot in the shrink's office.
So how you doing this week?
Good. Really good.
Really?
Yeah.
It's just not a bunch of faces saying words all day long, all through the entire episode. You can actually get out and get a little bigger and a little bit more cinematic. Now, obviously, that sequence by the river was even more so. But then it was the last scene in the last season.
Oh, no, 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 you're a rock and roll suicide. Ship break the snarling as you stumble across the road. But the day breaks instead, so you hurry home. Don't let the sun blast your shadow. Don't let the milk float, ride your mind. They're so natural, religiously unkind. Oh no, love, you're not alone.
The stuff on the rooftop was all shot at Sony on a set before we came out to New York to do all our location work. I knew it was going to be, we were going to be shooting Dusk for Dawn, and just kind of had to just eyeball it on the set against the green screen, hoping that the light would match whatever it was that we encountered when we got out on location in New York. And then the scene down by the river was tough because everything takes a long time to do, and you're trying to make the most of. We were shooting Dusk for Dawn. The second the sun had gone down, we started shooting, and it was still like really bright. But I got the Viz effects department on board and bought us a bunch more shooting time, but the lights on the bridges and the buildings weren't really reading. On those ones, we agreed with the Viz effects department that they were going to punch up, after we printed it all down to match what we were going to get right before it was too dark to shoot, that they were going to punch up the lights on the bridges and so forth and give it a little bit of snap so that it would match what it looked like when we got to the shots later on that we were actually shooting at the optimal time. But at the optimal time, usually you've only got time to do a couple of setups. That relationship ended up working really well, and I think it cuts really well.